Hi, I'm Jared. Welcome to Fun Science Demos. A big part of science is making things. We'll take a look at what I made. It's my flashlight. Today, we're going to show you how to make one of these. We've zoomed in so you can take a closer look at what you're going to need. You're going to need a popsicle stick, a battery, an LED light, a binder clip, and you can choose to use copper tape or electric paint. We got this paint from our friends at Educational Innovation, so big thumbs up to them. The first step is to attach our light bulb. Now keep in mind, with an LED light, one of the wires is longer than the other one. You need to make sure you know which side that is because the longer one is our positive side. So I'm going to slide this over the top of a popsicle stick. I need to make sure I keep track and remember that this is the positive side, so I just put a little plus sign. Now I'm going to run a piece of tape all the way down to the end of my popsicle stick. Peeling this can be a little bit of a pain, so take your time. Now, making sure the tape stays straight can be a little tricky. That's why the paint actually is easier to work with. Got my tape on one side, now time for the other side. Now, before I do the other side, I'm going to put my binder clip on the bottom here. Notice this metal clip is going to come into contact with that copper strip as well as when I flip that leg up. Now the other side, because I want it to be a switch, I don't want to take the copper tape all the way to the bottom. I want there to be a gap so that when I flip that leg, then it comes into contact with the copper. I want to be able to turn my flashlight on and off. So I'm going to take a really quick measurement, flip my leg down so I know how far to bring it down. Right about there. Let's attach this. So now you can see I have a gap, and the circuit will be complete when I've set my battery down and flip the switch. Let's give it a try. So our flashlight's ready to go. Our battery's gonna go on this side with the gap. Our other side has complete contact. This is our positive side. So I'm gonna make sure the negative side is down. Put my battery on, flip the switch, and it works. Next, we wanted to try our electric paint, and as you can see, I ran some electric paint along the whole length of that popsicle stick, and then I have a shorter length, and this is going to create my circuit. So let's put our binder clip on. You can see the metal's coming into contact with my electric paint. Flip that up. I now have one side of my circuit. There's the break in my circuit. I'm going to put the battery here, and when I flip my leg, it should complete the circuit. So let's give it a shot. Let's attach our battery, complete our circuit, and our flashlight works. Remember that the paint is much easier to work with in the beginning, but it does take up to a half hour to dry. The copper tape, it might be a little tricky to get on, but I can use it right away. We've also found that with a little bit of design, you can see we've taped our battery on with transparent tape and position it in such a way that it won't make a circuit when I flip my switch up. It only completes the circuit when I apply pressure. You can play around with this and try your own design to see what you can make your flashlight do. You can even try adding an extra battery to see what kind of results you get from that. We're using a whole pack of LED lights, and they're not expensive at all, and you can just get them online. We'd like to thank our friends from Educational Innovations for letting us take a closer look at their electric paint. If you want to learn more about electric circuits, or if you want some other design challenge ideas, check out our YouTube channel, Fun Science Demos. Science is so cool, especially when we get to build cool things. Thanks for watching.